What in the world is going on down here? What is this, a congregation of camels? No, wait, camels are in 1.20. These are llamas, and these are called a caravan. What group of animals is called a congregation? If you know what group of animals a congregation is called, let me know down in the comments. But I believe I have finally discovered why my area is so laggy. There is llamas galore down here and a bunch of other hostile mobs, so I think we're going to need to take some time to light up some areas and clear these out. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Alaydriem, and welcome back to the only YouTube channel here on YouTube where you have a dashingly good-looking cardigan-wearing Minecraft character. And today, in this episode, we're going to start things off by finding out where all these hostile mobs are that are lagging this area. We've got to take care of this because this area is becoming slightly unplayable, and I'm pretty confident now that it's not just my obscene abuse of using lanterns as a light source everywhere. So today we are going to first and foremost take care of lighting up a bunch of caves, and then we are going to do something here with potions, something that I have neglected to do because I haven't had a good use for it. And that use case is giving performance enhancing stimulants to our horses. Yeah, that probably sounds a little bit weird out of context, but I heard a rumor that if you give a splash potion of swiftness to two horses and then you breed them, the resulting offspring, at least in Bedrock Edition, will have the swiftness effect even with the potion not being applied. So I wanted to test this out just a little bit to see if it's true. And if it is true, I think what we're going to need to do is use this for both leaping and swiftness to create ourselves some obscenely fast and some obscenely high jumping horses here on our server. So a golden carrot to you, and you, and out should pop a new baby foal, which we're going to lead up right here. And horse, get out of the way. I'm gonna need to get another fence, aren't I? This place is getting a little bit cramped for four horses. Let's see, I'm sure I have a fence from this village I broke down. Let's see here, oak fence, that'll work just fine. Why don't you come over here, sweet little thing, tie you up to here. Yep, there we go. And now, if I can just get your attention without every other horses, we're just going to feed you golden carrots until you grow up. Because who wants to wait for horses to grow up when you can just give them that? Ah, there we go. I think you are ready. So, why can't I jump on your back? I have a saddle. Why are you angry with me? Do you need more? No? Horse. My horse is broken. I have broken my horse here on 1.19. What do I need to do? Surely you don't need more carrots. Ah, there we go. Perfect. Perfect. So, horse, love me. There we go. Horse loves me now. So now all we need to do is give him a saddle. And wait, hold on. Come back here. Don't be walking away like this. I have business with you. Let's see. Sleep real quick before it gets too dark. Morning. All right, horse, where'd you go? All right, saddle. Give you a saddle, and let's see how fast you are. I should probably have a way to measure this, shouldn't I? Let's just see. Let's just walk around and see how quick this horse is. Ooh, yes. That's quick. That is fairly quick. I think that's faster than the other horse that I had. And I think that's because it has the swiftness potion effect applied to it even after the potion is worn off. So I wonder, if I do this multiple times, can I make myself some super duper fast horses? But in order to do this, I'm gonna need more than three splash potions of swiftness. See, I can do this and this is fine, but I need more. I'm gonna need to make some super duper fast horses, and to do that we are gonna need ourselves a larger potion brewing room than what we— but before we do that, I want to make some alterations down here in our path. You see, I'm on this server all by myself. There's no one else here with me, but who can resist having a secret entranceway? I can't. I know I can't. So what I would like to do is play around with these shrieker skulks. The things that when you walk over them, they make noise and set off the shriekers that summon the warden. I want to play around with those and see if I can create a very simple door system that will allow me to trigger it from one side, but be completely hidden from the other. And I just realized that I don't have any water. We need to go get some water real quick. Be right back. And I'm back. So let's go ahead and try to build ourselves a door. I think we can do this with just some very simple pistons. Then we can take our shrieker. And I think we actually need to go down one more. Knock out this area around it. And then we're going to place some wool blocks. Yeah, let's place some wool blocks around this. And that will make it so that the shrieker will not go off unless we're walking directly above it. Place that there. And then we can get our water bucket. And if we place our water bucket over that, now it still will detect stuff, but it won't make the annoying sound that it makes. So I won't be freaked out every time I come down here. So we can go ahead now, and I think we can get away with placing a block directly above that. Let's see. Should see the particles coming out. Or probably the better way. Yeah, so saw a particle right there. Probably the better way to do that, though, is just to see if... let's try this real quick. Jump. Make some noise. Make some noise. There we go. Okay, yeah, it's working. So I think what we can do is we can get a comparator block to come out of this shrieker. And I think we can waterlog that. Yes. One of the few benefits of Bedrock is that we can waterlog all sorts of crazy things here. So yeah, there we go. Jump up on top of that. That sets off the comparator block. Now, the only thing we need to do is wire this up to this piston. So let's go ahead and what do we want to do? Grab a torch. Let's start here. I'm going to put a block there because I don't want that to set off, because otherwise this should be going on and off all day. So we'll try to keep this simple. Place a wool block here, and then we can knock out this here and here and here. And then we can place a torch there. That means it's inverted. And then we should be able to place a redstone dust here. And then I think if we place a block right here, now if we activate that, that should activate, I think, at least that bottom piston here. Let's go check that out real quick. Yes, bottom piston works. Okay, so now we just need to activate this top one. Let's go ahead and mosey ourselves around here to the back. Redstone dust obviously will not work, so I think we need another block. So maybe a redstone torch, and then place a block directly on top of it, and that should activate both. So now let's come down here. It closes. It opens. Oh, it's making noise and it's hearing itself. Let's place this here and jump. Yes, perfect. Opens and closes. Easy, simple door. Let's go ahead and just patch up this floor real quick. What item am I looking for? I don't want to place wool there. Oh, that still hears me. That's not a good sign. But it works. Aha, perfect. There we go. Now, wait a second. How do I get back over there? One second. Easy fix. So here we go. We now have ourselves a much prettier wall here on this side. So I've swapped the staircase position so that the staircase now winds over here and then gives us a straight shot to that main staircase if we ever need to use it. Moved our map up here, so if we're ever walking down, we can find that. This obviously goes straight up to our starter base. And now if we come down here, loop our way around, you can see we have a beautiful wall and you can't tell that anything's there. But secret button, press that button and go on through. That opens that. But on this side, if you walk through this, and I think if you jump, this door will open just like that. Aha, magic, brilliant. Now we can decorate this wall up with a few other things, but wow, these are really fun things to play around with. I hadn't played around with this. I had a button up here. That's kind of like wireless redstone right there. That button isn't connected to anything. It just makes a noise and that activates the shrieker skulk sensor. Skulk sensor, that's what they're called. I can't believe I forgot what they're called. That activates the skulk sensor, which means that button doesn't need to actually be wired or anything. And I think over here, we can just place a few random buttons over here, and now no one will know that one of these buttons opens a secret door. I mean, you know, because I just showed you all, but anyone else who's coming through won't have a clue. They'll just see the staircase here, and they won't know that I have a faster way up. It's brilliant. But now I think it's time to get on to our build of the day, which is making ourselves a much more enchanted potion room. And to make potions, we're actually going to need to come all the way out here. Do you remember where this is? This is where we had our wither skull farm. That's where we got all these withers from. But we need to come all the way out here because if I recall correctly, there is a super special item over here that we need. And that is blaze rods from all of the blazes that this thing has harvested for us. Look at that. Perfect landing. Now, where did I put those blaze rods? We'll put down our empty shulker boxes here. I should have a lot. Okay, rotten flesh. Nope. Some gold. Don't really care about that. Coal. That could come in handy. Bones. Lots of bones. Magma cream. Use that. Ah. Wait, that's all the blaze rods I have? thought I had more blaze rods. I must have taken them already and hid them somewhere in my base or used them. Probably ended up using them, but we'll go ahead and take care of all of this stuff as well. I imagine we'll have a use for this coal. At some point, we're going to run out of fuel source and we'll need to kickstart everything again. So let's go ahead and load all of these items here into our shulker boxes. And now that we have elytras, actually, we have a very unique opportunity available for us here. And that is clearing out... What is making noises up here? Things need to stop making noises. Anyway, now that we are here, we have a... Oh, here it is. This thing's on. Turn that off. Why did I leave that on? I must be crazy. We have a unique opportunity to clear out all of these floating blocks that we left here. So let's go ahead and fly around that real quick and clear this out. Oh, ow. Nope. Missed it. See, this one should be easy. I should be able to make this perfect landing in 3, 2, 1. Bam. First try. Brilliant. All cleaned up now. And then there's that one over there too. And now for the other one. Nope. 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 No, not even close. Yep. Nope. Got it. Almost. Nope. What was that? Nope. Hit it from the side. Why am I using a bow? Ow. Ow. Oh, I have an idea that might work. Let's try going over here to this area right here. Go ahead and zip on up. Let's sleep real quick. All right. And first try. Bam. Look at that. First time. I'm a professional Minecrafter. Yep. All right, now we can get rid of this block finally. Oh, that's been bothering you for as long as it's been bothering me. I hope that you are now cured. I didn't make those, so I'm just gonna leave them there. All right, so I think we now have everything we need. I just broke this platform. Let's go back to our base and start building our potion maker. And now, since I have the rockets to spare, we're gonna fly all the way back to our base because I now have the ways and the means to avoid completely going in the nether, and I'd rather waste a half stack of rockets than fly through the nether unnecessarily. But while we're flying back and unnecessarily loading a whole bunch of new chunks that I've never loaded before, let's maybe have a little chat and talk about what the direction of this channel is gonna go in starting in the new year. So, when this video comes out, it should be December 8th. I believe that's when I will have this scheduled. And we will have almost completed an entire year of posting a weekly video to the channel here. We've done a lot of different things on the channel. We have created redstone videos. We've created farms. We have done a Let's Play series going up over 21 episodes with this episode right here. And there's a lot of stuff in Minecraft that we have done. Certainly, there is still a lot left to do, but I'd love for it to hear from you down in the comments what things you would still like to see me tackle in this game. We have a whole plethora of things coming in the 1.20 update. Bamboo, all sorts of things with redstone coming in. But if there's anything specific that you would like to see in the upcoming episodes, let me know down in the comments, because the whole reason that I do these is for your entertainment and also because I think it's kind of fun. So if you have any ideas, let me know down in the comments. I would really love to hear from you. But wait a second. Is that really just a straight line? All right. That's our slime farm. And that's a random hole there. There's our other set of farms, our industrial district. So is this really a straight line shot? Normally, I travel through the nether to get here, so I actually don't know what this looks like over land. Certainly, I did not make a perfect line going from my base area. Ooh. Nope, sorry, we're taking a detour. Look at this. This is a complete sunken ship on dry land. It's not even broken. Look at this. Oh, this is just perfect. And anything in here? Oh, nope, nope. Nope, I will not be tempted by that. Look at this. A whole pirate ship just on land. I swear I didn't build this. This is all natural generation. Wow. Oh, it even has the rudder. Look at this. I've never seen this on a ship before here in Minecraft. That's the rudder of the ship that steers it. Wow. So I guess if you're looking how to build a ship in Minecraft, maybe just take a screenshot. Here's what the natural ones look like here in the game. Wow, that's incredible. Okay, I'm getting distracted. We have to head back home. And believe it or not, that is more or less a straight shot home. I may be veered off to the left 200 blocks, but otherwise I've just flown in a straight line. That's completely incredible that I somehow managed to build every single item in a straight line going east from west. Okay, it is now time, now that we have our items, to go ahead and build our potion brewing room. So let's go ahead and get that started. And we are now done. Well, here just about. I think we just have to knock out one more thing right here, and then we can maybe place the block here. Let's see. Just have one more thing. We have to add a lever here so that we can activate all of this and have our water bottles work. Go ahead and get a lever, pop that in there. That should work, I think. Yep, those empty out. Now I have all these water bottles empty out. We can go ahead and put all of these in storage, and oh, we are finally good to go. All right, so let me go ahead and show you how this works. As you can see here, brewing stand, we'll go ahead and let that fill up, and then we will lock that. That will prevent items from going down into this chest here, and we now have a brewing stand all ready to go. I have all of the potions that I want to make. This isn't all of the items that I can make in the game, but it's all the ones I really care about. I know swiftness isn't up here. I'm going to make a separate one for swiftness, but let's go ahead and start by making, what did I click on? A strength potion. Oh, go ahead. Go away, lover. Let's see here. So yeah, strength potion. So have another wart in there. That item will fall on down. Then our blaze powder will fall on down, making this a strength potion, I believe. And then we will have a piece of gunpowder come in. And because we have thousands of pieces of gunpowder, we can now make basically infinite splash potions, and this will then be a splash potion of strength, assuming I remember what blaze powder does. Yes, I am a genius who has a very good memory. All right, so this is now going to be a splash potion of gunpowder. Very, very simple little farm contraption to build. If you want to see how this farm is built and build your own version of these, I will leave a link down to a tutorial I made for this down in the comments so that you can make this for yourself in your own world. But just give this lever a little flick here. Those items will drain out. Go ahead and lock this, lock that. And we now have three new water bottles all ready for us to go here to make all of the potions that we could possibly ever. But that's going to be it for me here in this episode. I need to test out this potion theory on a few more horses and see if I can make the fastest, highest jumping horse ever possible in Minecraft. But as always, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video or want to see more, please consider leaving this video a like, consider subscribing, and remember, you're always welcome on Bedrock. I will see you guys in the next episode. Goodbye.